Which tools you will use depends on the situation. Whether you will do more than one engine overhaul, or only this one of your own classic VW. If you are doing this as an enthusiast, then time is less critical. You will avoid purchasing expensive tools and try to get the job done with a simple setup. A complete Type 1 engine with heat exchangers, exhaust, fan shroud, generator, weighs around 120 kilograms or 260 pounds. Working on the complete engine is easiest when the engine is on a workbench. To lift the engine on the bench, you will need at least two people. With a third person to guide the hole in the right direction is recommended. Even better and even safer is to use a garage crane or an engine lift. With this hydraulic lift table you can, without any help from a second person, move the long block or even the complete assembled engine. Here, we show how to support the long block to release it from the engine stand. A motor lifting table is not very expensive, and it will avoid irrevocably hurting your back. The workbench should be able to handle at least 200 kilograms or 440 pounds, ideally up to 300 kilograms or 660 pounds, to have a safety margin. The top of such a workbench is easily 4 centimeters or 1.6 inches thick. You want to run the engine on this workbench, so the workbench must also be able to handle the vibrations of the running engine. If you choose a mobile workbench like this one, then the wheels must be able to support at least 50 kilograms each or 110 pounds each. The advantage of a mobile workbench is that you can drive it outside to test the overhauled engine. You then do not have to use an exhaust extraction system for the exhaust gases during the tuning of the engine. Once the engine is disassembled to the bare crankcase, you have a long block that weighs about 60 kilograms or 130 pounds. A long block is the engine crankcase with cylinders and cylinder heads. This is still heavy, do not try to lift this alone. Always do that with two people, or use an engine lift table. Working on the long block can easily be done on a standard workbench or a standard table. A workbench that can handle a good 100 kilograms or 220 pounds is sufficient. Once the cylinder heads and cylinders are disassembled, you have a short block. The short block is the closed engine case with crankshaft, camshaft, and connecting rods. You can easily move a short block alone, without any help. You can split the crankcase halves on a standard workbench. We show you how in this video footage. This technique does require some caution. The crankshaft can fall out of the crankcase during the splitting of the crankcase halves. Our mechanic has enough experience to perform this operation without problems. You can do the entire engine overhaul with the crankcase on the workbench. It will quickly become apparent that this is not always convenient. But as a VW enthusiast, you probably don't mind that so much. To disassemble the short block parts and then reassemble them and attach the crankcase halves, it is quite difficult without an engine stand. It can be done, for example, by securing the left crankcase half and the workbench using old crankcase threaded rods. This is not ideal, but for an enthusiast this is workable. To be able to exert force when tightening the crankcase halves, the threaded rods were extra strengthened with a metal plate to be able to clamp them in the vise. An arrangement that you as an enthusiast can easily make yourself, there is even no welding involved. If you plan to work on engines on a regular basis, then the purchase of an engine stand is a good investment. In the Paruzzi online store, you can find such an engine stand, which is specially designed for air-cooled VW engines. Here we show how you can find this tool in our online store. Unfortunately, the engine stands you'll find in general auto parts stores will not always be suitable for an air-cooled VW engine. Here we show a professional engine stand. It can carry up to 900 kilograms or 1,980 pounds. So these engine stands have a wide safety margin for our air-cooled VW long block of 120 kilograms or 260 pounds. But as mentioned earlier, these are not adapted to our Type 1 engine, and we have to make adjustments before we can use them. We modified one of those generic engine stands to accommodate a Type 1 VW engine. As you can see, we did that by welding the head of an engine stand from the Paruzzi online store to a metal plate to be able to attach it to the generic engine stand. This way, we created a safe working environment to start the overhaul of our VW engine. You can't test run the engine on this engine stand. It has to be loose on the workbench, or it has to be mounted in the car. So the engine stand will only be used to work on the long block or the short block. It gives you an extra comfort. You can easily turn the engine crankcase to reach all parts of the engine. For an enthusiast, the Paruzzi engine stand is more than sufficient. You can use it without any modifications, mind you, only to attach the long block or the short block to it. The bolt at the top and the stud at the bottom that attaches the engine to the gearbox will need to be replaced with another bolt and stud to attach the engine to our engine stand. You can use the original engine mount hardware and use spacers. Or, you replace the bolt and stud end. We choose the latter solution. To loosen the lower stud end, we will use the two-nut method. Make sure the two nuts are tightened super tight against each other. You can then easily unscrew the stud end from the crankcase. Store the stud end and bolt carefully, you will need them again later. We replace the original upper bolt with a shorter bolt, a standard M10, with 1.5 pitch and a length of 4 cm. We replace the original lower stud end with a piece of threaded rod of 5 cm long, which is 2 inches. This will be attached using the two-nut method. The stud should stick out just enough to be able to attach the engine stand. When the stud is deep enough, the two nuts may be loosened. The motor is now ready to be attached to the engine stand. To attach the long block of our AB1300 motor to our engine stand, we use our motor lift table. You don't need any extra help to do this, and you don't have to strain your back unnecessarily. We make sure the top bolt and the bottom stud end are at the right height. We first secure the lower stud end with a spring washer and nut. Then it's the turn of the upper bolt, with spring washer and nut. You will need to move the engine around a bit to find the right position. The engine lift table is a good tool for this. We attached the long block to the engine stand, with its left crankcase half. For disassembly of the long block, it matters little which half you attach it to. For building up the short block, later in this video series, it will become apparent that you need to start with the left crankcase half. So the crankshaft and camshaft will need to be placed in the left crankcase half. So we make it a good habit to always attach the left crankcase half to the engine stand. Make sure all the nuts are properly tightened before you let the motor hang from the engine stand. An engine stand is not really necessary, but is definitely recommended to make the engine overhaul go smoothly and safely. An engine stand will make it very easy to work on any corner of the engine. This will prove to be very useful later on. We will use both a workbench with vise and an engine stand in this video series to show all the possible techniques. You can then decide for yourself which method is most suitable for you. In video 4, the distributor is discussed, because it is very important to correctly determine the position of the distributor to avoid having to disassemble the distributor drive shaft again after the overhaul. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments below each video on our YouTube channel. Keep a close eye on our newsletter for new videos and subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you soon.